The redesign of its Raptor engines will significantly alter SpaceX's Starship, a rocket headed for Mars. This update aims to make it the most potent engine ever created by promising a monumental revolution and a significant increase in power. The entire rocket industry has experienced shockwaves as a result of this development. This video episode will examine the Raptor 3 engine's performance in comparison to other engines and how SpaceX's future will be impacted by this improvement. Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, has had Mars as his ultimate goal since the company's creation in 2002. The business started off with unmanned flights of the Little Falcon 1, moved on to commercial missions with a bigger Falcon 9, and finally conducted crewed flights to near-Earth orbit. Their formidable launch vehicle must have powerful engines, a propulsion system for long space operations, and a propellant landing and ascent architecture suitable for Martian conditions if they are to achieve their lofty goal. The SpaceX Raptor engine family will meet all of these requirements. The SpaceX exclusive SX500 alloy, which is used to make the Raptor engine, is composed of copper, aluminum, and steel alloys. The engine runs on liquid oxygen and liquid methane in a cryogenic state. It is extremely effective because it uses a full-flow staged combustion cycle, FFSCC, to maximize the specific impulse produced by propellants. Notably, the Raptor engine can flip and burn land with the Starship thanks to its 15-degree gimbaling range on the Y and Z axes. To overcome obstacles, the Raptor engine's development went through several revisions. Despite being an older and more complicated design, Raptor 1 produced 185 tons of force but required a lot of time to launch. After the initial Starship orbital flight, Raptor 2 attempted to fix some of these problems but ultimately fell short. 3 weeks later, Raptor 3, an updated and more potent rocket engine, was unveiled to suit the needs of a Starship headed for Mars. It significantly increased power, reaching 350 bars of pressure and producing 269 tons of thrust. 185 tons of thrust were produced by Raptor 1 compared to 230 tons by Raptor 2 and 269 tons by Raptor 3. Furthermore, Raptor 3 attained higher chamber pressure, which results in more thrust and perhaps even greater efficiency. The top Russian engine, the RODE-180, produces 386 tons of thrust in contrast but is dependent on two combustion chambers and nozzles. The combined thrust of two Raptor 3 engines would be much greater if they were installed in a single RODE-180's place. The Blue Origin B4 engine, with its estimated 240 tons of thrust, is inferior to the Raptor 3 in terms of output. With 33 Raptor 3 engines, the Starship Super Heavy booster's overall thrust would be 19.5 million pounds or 8,877 tons. In contrast, the defunct Saturn V rocket produced 7.6 million pounds or 34.5 million newtons of thrust. The thrust of the Saturn V would therefore be 2.56 times greater when the Starship Super Heavy booster was powered by Raptor 3 engines. Questions have been raised about SpaceX's ability to launch the Raptor 3 engine by the end of the year after officials there recently claimed that they have more engines than they can currently fly. For vehicles equipped with Raptor 3, the greater power means a significantly higher cargo capacity. Raptor 3 may also be launched again in an hour as opposed to several weeks with Raptor 1, because to its simplicity. This engine is groundbreaking and cost-effective due to its decreased production cost compared to earlier iterations. The Raptor 3 engine has effects that go beyond its improved cost-effectiveness and power. The ultimate goal of SpaceX is to populate Mars, and the Raptor 3 engine's short turnaround time makes it possible for several flights each week. SpaceX may launch more payloads into space in a year than the United States has done in its entire history with a modest fleet of Starships outfitted with Raptors 3. For the purpose of constructing a self-sustaining Mars colony, this significant increase in annual payload capability is essential. Elon Musk calculates that it would take 1 million ton of payload to establish a self-sustaining Mars colony. This may be completed in under 10 years with Raptor 3 equipped Starships and 20 launches per week. To put it another way, 1,000 Raptor 3-equipped Starships operating continuously for 10 years would be sufficient to accomplish this task. Even though such a project would be expensive, the Raptor 3 engine has a notable benefit. The cost of launching a Raptor 3-equipped Starship is anticipated to be only $2 million, as opposed to the $1.55 billion to $2 billion per launch cost of NASA's SLS rocket, which can carry 15% less cargo than the Starship. The Starship is 1,040 times less expensive than the SLS in comparison. Beyond Mars colonization, the Starship and Raptor 3 engine have other uses. The Starship has the potential to be the first net-zero rocket in the world because to its compatibility with carbon-neutral biofuels. Additionally, it might be a feasible alternative to commercial jet aircraft due to its excellent landing capability and payload capacity of over 150 tons for low Earth orbit. Consider making the trip from London to New York in just 29 minutes for the same price as each passenger's usual first-class ticket. A fleet of Starships outfitted with Raptor 3 could transport passengers without experiencing substantial delays, but Raptor 1's slow turnaround time rendered this service impracticable. In conclusion, SpaceX's Raptor 3 engine represents a revolutionary development in rocket technology. It has the potential to change space exploration, Mars colony initiatives, and even have an impact on Earth by altering aviation thanks to its improved power, cost-effectiveness, and short turnaround time. SpaceX hopes to use the Raptor 3 engine to open up the Moon, Mars, and asteroid belt for additional human exploration and habitation.